So hi, it's Jason here with part two of my epilogue. This will complete my discussion on why I think the country's in a civil war. So why does the liberal media ignore heinous threats against conservatives by the left and pursue the unsubstantiated charges leveled by liberals? Well, the simple answer is they're biased, but I think there's something deeper going on here. If you've noticed, I think that their reporting on issues like these have delegitimized them in the past year almost completely. So I think it is natural for any conservative or anyone even opposed to Obamacare to distrust the mainstream media and start building the infrastructure of an alternative communications network. This is already happening, and because so many people desire such an endeavor to succeed, I think that is even further evidence we are essentially in a civil war. When you look at the incredible ratings of Fox News in 2009, for instance, I think that is part of a cultural rebellion on a level most people are afraid to admit. The mainstream media certainly won't admit to that, right? The total and complete rejection by conservatives and libertarians of the channels through which the liberal establishment conveys its cultural values is being met by the liberal establishment in a desperate attempt to halt the rebellion with their ace in the hole. And that explains the frequent use of the race card and that particular historical narrative. If the left has lost control of people through the constant battering ram of white guilt, they are determined to now punish those same people as they with false hate crime charges, false accusations of racism, as those people shake off the shackles that they have been held in for so long by the mainstream media. So now, what is being fully exposed by the media's acceptance of the liberal establishment's cultural cliches about race, and especially this idea of manufacturing hate crimes against people who are innocent, is that the establishment media will never change. The media is a liberal tool, and it will be controlled by the left forever. But the United States has reached a tipping point in its history. Most people are beginning to really understand that. Either socialism succeeds and people like the ones behind the tweets I read on this post ascend, or conservatism manages to retool and becomes in counter-revolution, an engine of broad sweeping change that discredits big government and socialism and identity politics, and statism forever. What we are going through is a poignant historical political moment, and don't let them convince you to go back to sleep. The future is dependent on the outcomes of the political battles of today. The future of the country will be determined by the victor of this civil war. It is naive to believe that the media and the left will ever change. And it's worthless to try to change them. You know, that's why we have to rebel and build a conservative network. Marxist strategy dictates the left will never waver from their position. So, you know, that is perhaps why the media will overlook the abusive language used against Ohio Republican Representative Gene Schmidt this past week. You know, a caller to her office left a heinous voicemail. And it's been almost completely overlooked. What he said is this: "Yeah, I'm glad the president passed health care. Yeah, funky-ass, racist-ass Republicans. Hate that, don't you? Gene Schmidt, when you got hit by that car, you should have broke your back, bitch. And Boehner, motherfucker, that Mitch McConnell, all you racist fucking Republicans, why don't you just change your party name to racist? Because if one of those fucking teabaggers had spit on me, I'd have shot all of them in the fucking face with my fucking 9mm. Fuck all you racist motherfuckers. So you see, this is the kind of thing, along with many others, that cuts right into the liberal leftist paradigm and undercuts their historical narrative. And it is uncomfortable because it forces the question, who are really the racists here? And exactly who are the ones inciting violence? And I'll leave you with that.